plagiarism. Fair use. Copyright.
Hello guys, it's me, Keanini. It's been a long time since I'm making a vlog, so this is really wonderful. So now I'm gonna do some talking about just three topics. First of all, it's copyright, fair use, and the other one, which is plagiarism. So I guess three topics are very similar to each other because it's all about protecting your source material. So I'm gonna talk each and every one of those. So let's start on copyright. So copyright, according to the Intellectual Property Office of the Philippines, this copyright defines as a legal protection extended to the owner of the rights in an original work. So this means like to protect when you have your original work and you have to protect it to avoid stealing. So that's what you call copyright. You have your own sense, I mean your own protection with copyright. If it's not copyrighted, somebody else will steal your work, and that's what you call plagiarism. Plagiarism is the act of kind of stealing your ideas or a song or any other material like ever. And there's fair use. Okay, so fair use is a wonderful kind of, what do you say, this wonderful use, because in fair use, you can give credits to the owner, and even though it's without permission, but you give credits, and that's fair use, like fair use. So I'm in my room now. I'm actually in my grandmother's room, and copyright. I'm gonna talk first about copyright. So there in IP. According to the IPO, the following works are protected by the Intellectual Property Code, such as the books, your books, pamphlets, articles, and other writings, periodicals, newspapers, musical composition like your own lyrics, and computer programs. Like, oh my god, you really made an app like for yourself, and somebody's gonna copy it. So this is really copyright. And also drama works, literary works, and also songs. So this is an example. This is a book, and this is a copyright. This is under a copyright because, for example, the author name is Fernando Aboga, and he owns this book. Like he made this book, so it's under a copyright list. As you can see here, in the book there is a copyright by Tech Factors. The one who printed this is under Tech Factors, and it's like the authors is Fernando Aboga, so it's really his book and their book, Tech Factors. If you caught stealing it, so that's what you call plagiarism. Like you're gonna copy everything about this book. Like for example, you have the lesson 7, which is what is the information of the recycle, and you just copy all the words under it, like it's the same headline, uplining, and whatsoever, and it's called plagiarism. So in fair use, you can just add some quotes, and you just cite what book it is. Like for example, I quote, in legal action, the physical arm in lesson 10 in the Tech Factors book, the major information there. Literacy as code, there will be inevitably be those who think threatening journalists with legal action, such as hitting them with a libel suit, and end of quote. So you should actually cite your code so that it will be called as a fair use. Like also in researches, you have decided in your review of related literature, citing citations can help you avoid plagiarism. So plagiarism is a very serious case of TEF for me, because you can actually go to prison, and fair use, you should cite, and it's also without asking for permission, so all you have to do is just cite. So I'm gonna give you an example. Like, for example, I made a song, and it's called, Today's a Holiday, and I made a song, I made the lyrics, I made the composer. So, this friend, Miss Kristen Ray, copied some part of my lyrics, which is I-Code, because it's my copyright. So, I-Code, love me baby, I love my holiday, today is a holiday. So, she entered it in my song, like, in her song, I mean, like, her song is called Holiday Blues, and it's like copying my song, and the tune of my original song is like, then hers is like, so it's really copying, and it's not fair, unfair. So that is plagiarism. Like, for example, which I can guess, just Peekaboo by Seokjin and the Banshees. They have a lyric called like, golly jeepers, where do you get those creepers, creep show, freak show, where do you get those eyes. So a lot of critics said it was similar to an old song, which is Jeepers Creepers, I guess, in 1937. So what they do is just they add the lyricists of the Jeepers Creepers to their own song, Peekaboo, so they'll be credited, so to avoid plagiarism. So that is what you call fair use. And also they just ask permission as also. So fair use is a very wonderful again use, because you can just cite and you don't need permission. You just cite. So I'm gonna share you what is in the book. Oh my god, I forgot. So in plagiarism, like, cheating is also a part of plagiarism, because for example, you're writing an essay and your test, so this guy is in your side and everyone is looking, and he is looking in your paper, like, oh my god, is he a giraffe? And so it's very, very not good. Like, seriously, hey, like, when it's time for checking, like, for example, I wrote an essay about I love my day, it's wonderful, the beautiful grass, the beautiful trees are loving me, and he's like also like that, like, I love my house, I love my family, and the green grass, the grass, the trees are loving me. So it's really like the same, and it's really cheating. Like, no, why are you cheating? So that's really an issue. Plagiarism. You are going to prison. So after that, I'm gonna talk about fair use. Okay, so fair use, according to Wikipedia, is a doctrine in the law of the United States or any places that permits limited use of copyrighted material without having to first acquire permission to the copyright holder. So fair use is one of the limitations to copyright intended to balance the interests of copyright holders with the public interest in the wider distribution and use of creative works by allowing certain limited uses that might otherwise be considered as copyright infringement. So examples of fair use, like, first is research. Like, research, like, you really need to cite sources, like, in your review of, like, literature, like, it's really important. Next up, we have parody. So parody is like, for example, you're having a video, like, for example, Taylor Swift is having an Endgame video, and this parody maker named Bart Baker is a superstar in parody, and he makes parodies like without even asking permission. Like, also his parodies are like are like very bad to Taylor Swift. For example, like in Blank Space, like Mark Beaker's bird, he said like you need to pay for my album. So it's also fair use because you can just copy what is on the video of Taylor Swift. So it's really fair use if we do parodies. Also, you can do covers of your favorite song if you have the permit, if it's in privacy and it's not for public use. If you want to do covers of your favorite artists, you should first ask the permission, like the permission of the recording company probably, or the, yeah, for the higher major record labels. Hello, I'm back. So, with the major labels such as WMG, Warner Music Group, or UMG, which is Universal Media Group, I guess. So, if you caught in YouTube posting a cover without permission, and maybe they'll sue you for a copyright notice if you don't put credits on it. Just for me, for example, I posted a video of a dub smash of Little Mix, Black Magic. So I don't own the song, so they gave me a copyright notice, and that's the time when I deleted all my videos on YouTube. So it's really very sad. So that's all for today for the copyright, the fair use, and the plagiarism. So again, copyright is to protect. So again, for my meanings, copyright means to protect the protection of your original work. Plagiarism is the act of copying or stealing, and fair use is you need to cite without permission. You can use it for use, but for only private. So see you guys for the next video, and thank you for watching Keanini's Vlogs X, the Unkabongable Interviewers. Bye.